My name is Claudia Veit. I work for the Zurich University of Applied Science. And here with me today from like the core team of this international virtual course is Anna Geiser, who, as I said previously, keeps all the loose ends together, as she just demonstrated with this presentation. So yes, it's really great to be here today to present this virtual summer school, as it was initially called. We now changed the name to International Virtual Course because some of the project partners said it's not summer while this is happening, it's raining all the time and it just doesn't work that way. The title is Tackling Climate Change Through Global Learning. Next slide. I can't do this myself, sorry. Now, the main idea and goals behind all of this is that when I joined the ZHAW in the end of 2018, I was approached to develop this international but climate neutral and therefore virtual summer school, because our supervisor said we have so many in-person summer schools, but sometimes the feedback is, why do we have all this flying around? Why do we like create these CO2 emissions? And so we started developing this idea early 2019. This is important just because it was before Corona. That's something to keep in mind. And I have a background in development cooperation. I worked after my university studies in geography, I worked in the development sector for around 10 years. And I said, this is something very relevant because it's kind of an international experience that is not normally part of, let's say, the formal education system. It's this very daily business situation. And I thought, yes, this could be something really interesting. And I have to say that in a way, the idea captured a bit the spirit of the time back then, because all these keywords like sustainability, internationalization, and digitalization, they were all part of, let's say, the strategic papers of academic institutions and so on. So it was relatively easy to get financing for the next 5 years. And the idea is to then admit it to the regular curriculum afterwards. Now, very briefly, the learning objectives, the two key learning objectives behind this are that the students are able to collaborate effectively across cultural borders via virtual channels. I would say this was really like the main focus. And then the thematic topic component that came afterwards. That's based on my background, on the background of the team. Then basically we said, okay, climate change is this global challenge. So it makes sense that people from all over the world work together to solve this problem or to work on this problem. But it's also a very good example of how it's different depending on the different localities, the different geographies, and so on. Then next slide. Those are the partner institutions. So it's the ZHAW and then the UFGD from Brazil. They are with us since the beginning. And also the UASB from India, they are also with us from the beginning. Those were previous contacts with the UASB. We even had like an in-person live summer school before that. So this was really great because we could build upon those contacts, and they were also part of like the development of the idea. And then in 2020, we did the pilot, the three of us, and already in the project proposal, we had stated that each year we would admit an additional partner up to a total of 5 institutions, because yeah, there is a point where it gets a bit very complicated to manage. So for this year's edition, we had the University of Nairobi from Kenya who joined. And I have to say, it's a great package of expertise. We have like the environmental perspective. The UASB has a rather economic expertise. The Universidad Federal de Grande Dourados is very strong in social science. And then the Kenyans are very strong in soil science. So we have this mixture, and I have to say we really benefit from each other, from the different geographies. When students talk about the excursions that they did and so on, they all have different positions in international climate negotiations. And then it somehow comes together in the international virtual course. Also, and this is probably interesting to know, we have students with very different backgrounds, be it from like a climate change knowledge point of view, but we also have bachelor students, PhD students. And I have the feeling that so far this has really never been an issue, those different academic levels. It's been rather beneficial. They've appreciated this. And what's very central that was already in the project proposal is this collaboration at eye level between the different institutions, like for the project staff team, but also with the students. And we try to implement this. We have, and we'll see that in the next slide when I talk about the structure of the course, we tried to really divide responsibilities and tasks. We from ZHAW, we have the main project lead. That's something we can't really change, but that's really what guided a bit the development and the cooperation. Next slide. Thank you, Anna. Here you can see the setup. So this international virtual course is divided in four phases. We have the preparation from a local perspective. That's phase one. And here the main task is that the students elaborate a 10-minute video in which they document the challenges, the impacts of climate change in their specific country, in their region. And then before the start of phase two, I mean, here you can see that there are other components to this phase one. They also do the FAO e-learning course, just so that they have a basic knowledge of the topic. But that's really the main task for this phase one. And then when we transition into phase two, the so-called virtual classroom, which is the most intensive phase of this international virtual course, they have a look at the videos and so on as like an introduction of climate change in the different countries. And then here you can see, next slide, Anna, just for a second. Here you can see the schedule of this year. So we have one case study from each country. We have the national activities, as we called them. The idea was that those are excursions. However, due to Corona, that was not possible in all the countries. Then we have the day after those national activities, students then report to each other about what they did the previous day. So this year, those countries that were not able to go on excursions, they studied a paper and presented the lessons or the main points of those papers. We organized panel discussions with like one expert from each country per topic. We had a workshop on international collaboration by an expert from SAFO. And in general, this program was really very much appreciated from the students. Now, Anna, can you go back to the previous slide? Sorry. And this is this virtual classroom. And then already during the second phase, we start with the third phase because we realized that the third phase is it's the most challenging. Here they work together in international teams. So the idea is that each team has one member from each country, and they work together over, this year was around 3 weeks, to develop an innovative solution strategy to tackle climate change. That is like the big task. They write a proposal of 10 pages and record a PowerPoint presentation to present it then. And this is all then followed by a reflection part, the closing event, the evaluation, because the idea is really that they also reflect. And this has worked quite well in the past, that they reflect what they've done during those, especially the second and the third phase. Now you can go 2 slides ahead to the experiences and lessons learned. Thank you. So far, I have to say that we are very lucky because the collaboration among the partner institutions is very good so far. We realize that it's a steep learning curve if a new partner joins. That was quite challenging, but they and I, we managed quite well, I would say. The course is in constant development. There was a substantial change from the first to the second year, and we are now just in the phase of like evaluation. How do we do it next year? So it's great to get your inputs afterwards. In general, we received quite positive feedback and the interest from all kinds of different angles, which is really motivating, I would say, yes. Then Corona was obviously a topic for everyone. It required substantial changes, like no excursions, widespread digitalization. We had the feeling it's not as innovative as it was when we developed the idea back then. However, it was still possible to be implemented, and that was especially relevant for the Brazilians in 2020 when there were no other university courses taking place. So that was very good. The evaluation results are in general quite positive. The students appreciate this intercultural exchange, the collaboration, and this easy access from a financial point of view, for example, to make this international experience without additional costs was stated or perceived as something very positive. Especially the Brazilians also said, and I would say this is like a easy access from a social point of view, that for them the barrier to apply for an international summer school abroad with their sometimes limited English skills would have been much higher. So I'd say we have a different target audience in a way that a traditional summer school would have. We realized that there is a lot of communication efforts needed. Like, I have the feeling we are communicating all the time, and still sometimes we don't get the message across when to be where and how. And yeah, that's a challenge for us. Then for the virtual classroom, the second phase, the evaluation showed that the students would have, like, they liked the program overall, but that they would have appreciated more time for breakout room sessions, for the professional exchange amongst them, for like also informal virtual socializing. And this is now like processing for next year. But I have the feeling that in a way, maybe we can let go even more and provide platforms for them to work together, because the experience is they work together really well. It's not that they then start chatting about whatever, but that they actually want to know about the topic, which is very great. And then the virtual teamwork phase 3, as I mentioned, it's very challenging for them, this experience to work across different time zones and so on. And here from our side, the coaching almost can't be close enough, so we have to be very it requires a lot more effort, I would say, than a coaching at ZHAW. would internally. I think that's in, yeah, very briefly tried to explain what it's all about. The next slide is already challenges and points for the discussion. So if something is not clear about the concept, maybe we could clarify this before we move to the discussion. And otherwise, I'm very happy to present the challenges that we are facing. Yes, the challenges for the discussions. We identified two very challenging points at this point. The Corona fatigue. How does such a virtual offer remain attractive in times of Corona and increased exclusive online lessons? Also, when we look ahead in times of increased digitalization post-Corona, it was in for the edition 2021 this year, we didn't find enough Swiss students, to be honest. The target or the idea is to have 10 from each country. And with massive like marketing communication efforts, we got 5 students in the end. And the partner universities, it was easier for them. They kind of filled up our empty spaces, but still, yes, I mean, our interest is also to have students from our institution from Switzerland participating. How can we keep that attractive? And then also, I believe this is a challenge in a lot of online teaching to increase the students' commitment. They had, or at least some of them had, very irregular participation. They were very passive in class. And how this can be, from your experience, it's interesting for us to hear how, yes, this can be improved.